Good afternoon. this is a really nice opportunity for me to kind of further my research. I've been working with biodiversity data from social networks. So basically, my interest started in biodiversity as a naturalist, and I by chance got into IT field. But then again, immediately after finishing my master's, I came back to biodiversity. I started working for the Foundation for Revitalization of Local Health Traditions, where I initially started looking at a database of medicinal plants, and then got more involved with the distribution mapping of some of the rare medicinal plants in India. And that's when I also got involved with some of the naturalist groups, and we started some Yahoo group communities to start with, and then expanded to, of course, most of the modern social networks like Facebook and Flickr and all these popular sites. Basically, what happens is most of the naturalists who are not really biologists take a lot of photographs, and then they want to share it, so they post it on one of these websites. Over last 5-6 years, most of these websites have become kind of spatial aware, so you can actually pinpoint the location of your photograph. Some of the cameras and recent mobile phones also have GPS built in, so the location comes in, and people tend to tag it with scientific name, common name, or whatever information they have, and also have interaction. Like, then some expert or someone who has seen that organism says, no, this is probably this or that, even if they don't know it. So there is a lot of this information being gathered. Most of these people are not really interested in taking trouble to put it on something like iNaturalist or India Biodiversity Portal, what we have within India. So I thought, can we kind of, in some kind of semi-automatic way at least, harvest some of this information and see if this is useful or not? And this exploration kind of started. I started with Jorge. We were talking about monarch butterfly and whether can we really see where all it how it migrates and where all it migrates and things like that. I started writing some script, extracted some data, and it is really showing good trends. In fact, I just heard 2 days back that my proof of concept paper is accepted and should be out in probably a month's time in ecological informatics. So that's the beginning. Now, what using this opportunity, I'm going to use is I'm working on two case studies. One is the whole bird species, all bird species of the world. So I wanted to basically check with data source like GIB if it has like more than 200 million records, but can I still add something using all these explorations, or for these kind of taxa is it going to be just redundant and I don't have to bother about it? The second case study I am working is on Indian butterflies, because I know on networks like GBIF, insect data is sparse, and especially for countries like India, there is hardly anything. So that's where I am also looking at the quality parameters, because I am familiar with butterflies in India and I have a group of friends who are willing to help me. So what we are going to do is actually look at most of these photographs individually and what they are tagged, and see whether that identification was correct or wrong, or was it correct at say only genus level, you cannot confirm species and things like that. So there is I'm actually in the process of developing a little software to do this, and probably on a website where more and more researchers can come and say, okay, I'm interested in this species, this area, can you give me the records, and I will kind of validate them and then use the usable information. So these are the kind of explorations I'm doing. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank, obviously, first thing GBIF, because that's where all these explorations started. Can I add something to that in my little way? So, and the GBIF Science Committee. I'm also thankful to the Indian delegation who actually forwarded my application for the thing, especially Bibi Mathur, Gautam, and Hem Pandeji, who have done that. I'm also really thankful to the whole team in the University of Kansas, where I started all these actually on like on exploration. So Tom Peterson, Horace Oberon, my advisor Chris Brown, Chip Taylor, all these people have been really supporting and encouraging me to do this. My home organization, of course, FRLHT, which kind of gave me initial exposure to biodiversity informatics, and finally my family, who have been like supporting all my naturalist crazy ideas and explorations, and letting me work in whatever I wanted to. So thank you all.